Hey guys, Tyler here, OnceInLuv. I'm here today to talk about my top five RTA 2As. So fifth place for me is Bella or Escher. One base speed, two attack bar push. They're kind of options for Swift, they're options for Nemesis. We've seen them a couple times in the SWC. We actually saw Bella, I believe, in the finals. Hopefully we'll see Escher in some future competitive play. The fourth one for me would be Rauk, or also, as some of you know, Rauk Sina. His best strength is actually not his team up or the fact that he can have an infinite amount of hits, but his passive. So the Annihilate passive that gives him an extra turn helps you snowball a lot in content, whether it's RTA or Guild Wars. Once you get that first kill, or if you get an extra violent proc, you just start to snowball. You take extra turns, you team up more and more, and it just becomes out of control really, really fast, especially if there's a Vert or an Alshari there, you just start dealing a ton of damage. I feel like Rauk is more situational. He's good in very specific comps, but he's not one of those units where you can kind of just pick it in and it's like an easy counter pick. Big shout out to the Wind Marshall Cat. A lot of people don't think she's very good. She's very good in PvE. Shout out to Naomi. So this is where the list really starts. Number three is gonna be Mina. First of all, she has insane base speed. Second of all, she doesn't need any crit. So the passive for her is if the enemy's not debuffed and you don't glance, you will crit guaranteed. So you hit somebody and then you'll also use your skill one an extra time if you crit. So if you skill two and you crit, then you'll also skill one afterwards. So you get a lot of chances for extra damage, a lot of multi-hits. You're able to kill Verds, Garros, Daphnis, some squishy Franz and Lorenz. Overall, because she doesn't need to have crit rate, you can run builds with like plus 1.6k attack, 280, 290 speed, and then like 190, 200 crit damage. And because she's so fast and she has that base speed, generally you don't need will on her either. One of the fun things about Mina though, is because people are so used to that build, you can mind game people and run a Bruiser Mina on Violent. So you become this like scary version of an Aegir that's just more damage and less utility. Number two, I really wanted her to be number one, Alusia. I think she is one of the strongest units in the game. Base stats are phenomenal. Amazing kit, really low cooldowns. Her skill three is a two-turn sleep that is irresistible as long as you don't glance. Amazing counter versus LD nat fives. It's really good versus the Artemil. It's really good versus the Ragdoll. Her cooldowns are really low, so she's flexible for rune builds. She doesn't need to have will. Revenge is a very good option. Stats are really good options. And the multipliers for her damage are insanely high. If you're a little ambitious, you can definitely run a crit damage Alusia. I would say she is the best candidate for skill ups out of every single 2A unit. And then coming in at number one, my absolute least favorite unit is Miho. The reason I don't like her so much is she outshines and outclasses a lot of units. Garo passive, like a passive, she kind of like just overlooks all of them and says, I'm your master now. But the reason Miho is so strong is because of her passive. So her passive says she cannot die to crits. I 1v3'd somebody yesterday, Perna, Ragdoll, and Avert, because, you know, that's just how Miho passive works. She's one of those units that you have to force ban in a lot of situations. When you crit her, she's also guaranteed to counter you with a crit, and she gains 30% attack bar, and she has 119 base speed. And her skill one gives her built-in lifesteal. So technically you don't need Vampire, but Vampire is really good on her. Yeah, she's crazy. With Mina, Alusia, and Miho, it's either this unit is an extremely good counter pick, or this unit is just easily fits in most comps. You know, it's not hypocritical, but you know, I did have to build a Miho. You know, I want to compete as well. You know, I got that Arena Defense Miho, got the RTA Miho, got the Guild Wars Miho. You can mainly find me on Twitch. I stream at 6 p.m. Pacific every single day. I'm actually currently at 137 days in a row without missing a day.
137 for real?